policies that attempt to increase the birth rate are unpopular, but ultimately, wouldn't they generate a more sustainable and organic way of increasing population rather than bringing into the country adults who need housing immediately and who need that provided in the short term?
Yeah, well, I mean, certainly migration adds to the housing problem immediately, because people come over here usually as adults and they go straight in the housing market. Whereas if obviously, children are born, it takes them 20 years pretty much to hit the housing market. So certainly in terms of housing, natural increase through births is a much better approach. That is also obviously very expensive. And I'm also a big believer in choice. I believe people should have as many children as they want. And I'm not really a big fan of this sort of big government telling people, you got to have more kids, whatever. It's really a personal choice in my view.
Yeah, fair. Instability in the cost of construction, with prices rising several times in the course of the timeline for the build of something really as simple as a family home, are providing a disincentive to normal people to engage in the contract for a new home build, affecting the building start numbers. To what extent do you see industrial relations policies, which have really been quite prominent in the mind of Labor governments, particularly federal but also state, playing a part in the lack of confidence in consumers for new residential builds?
Look, I'll be the first to admit that industrial relations is probably, beyond my wheelhouse of expertise. But what I will say is the notion that we can magically ramp up housing supply when we've got obviously high interest rates, we've got shortages of materials, shortages of labour, we've seen a whole swathe of builders go bankrupt, is quite frankly delusional. Yeah. Again, the solution to Australia's housing supply problem is really to lower population growth, to keep demand, demand through population increase commensurate with supply. Unfortunately, you don't fix supply problem by ramping up demand, as the Albanese government has done through its unprecedented immigration program.
Leith, before I let you go, New South Wales Liberal leader Mark Speakman has copped a bit of a pasting over his comments around the importance of population growth. He said it's in the country's best interests, quote, economically and strategically, to have sustained but sustainable population growth. Take a look at this.
Well, those sort of colourful comments I made, I'm not suggesting we're going to be invaded in the next year or 5 years or necessarily at all. I'm just making the point that in the long run, you have a stronger economy and a stronger country if you have a steady increase in population that grows your tax base, which allows you to spend money on defence.
Yeah, it's certainly
Leith, this has been reported as a really... Oh, sorry, I'll let you go.
Oh, no, I was going to say, it's a very interesting comment. I think, I think Mark Speakman's actually rolling back his comments to the Daily Telegraph last week, where he's a lot more forceful about big Australia. Look, all I'll say to Mark Speakman is that this isn't 1940s Arthur Caldwell Australia. There is no populate or perish. The population in 1950 in Australia was 8 million. It's 26.4 million now. So the whole notion that we've got this, we have to grow the population for our own security is quite frankly ridiculous. Wars are not won through manpower. The one for technology and alliances and that sort of thing. In terms of, I do agree with him that, we need population growth to be sustainable. But unfortunately, what the projections aren't sustainable. The 2023 intergeneration report predicted that Australia's population would grow by 14 million people in just 40 years. Now, that's over 50%. And what that is, that's effectively a Sydney, Melbourne, Brisbane and Adelaide in just 40 years, which is absurd numbers. And this is, Speakman, I don't think, if Speakman's is endorsing that, he's just quite frankly crazy. Most voters, as we know through various opinion polls, do not support such strong population growth. They want to dial back significantly. And, my personal view is it's about time that politicians like Mark Speakman represent voters rather than their big business mates, because we are not being represented by political leaders, both sides of politics.
Hey, fighting words. Thank you very much for your time tonight, Leith Van Onselen.